Hello and welcome to the Vector Garden YouTube channel. In this video, we're going to take a look at some more new features of Illustrator 27.6.1. So besides the AI-powered functionality, there are some functions that might sound minor, but might play an important role in your workflow. So let's go through them in no particular order. The first one I want to present is a functionality in the Layers panel. We're going to Window Layers, and there's the Layers panel. And your artwork might have several layers and a difficult layer structure, and there are hierarchies in it, and you want to find stuff. So in order to find stuff in the Layers panel, one option that already exists is you select something on the artboard and then click on the search tool. And there you've got your thing in the Layers panel. Now you see there's one of them name. I've given it an individual name. Let's close this and deselect. And you might want to find things by their name in the Layers panel. So this is new. You can enter that name up here, and I'm going to search for it. And then you can also filter that. So there might be several things named as fencer in this file, and some of them might be text, and some of them might be other things. So you can filter it. Click on this funnel icon, and then you can also filter it. You want to get only the shapes by that name, but it's not the case in here. So the next thing is you type return, and then you think, well, nothing happened. Where do I find it? So open the layer, and there you have the thing you have been searching for. So the Layers panel is now limited to the things you search for. This might also be irritating, so once you found it and done what you wanted, get rid of this. And also go in here and clear all. So once you have clicked on something, then you see something is set and you can clear all, and then you can again see everything in the Layers panel. Next thing is a new option in the Color panel. So let's go to Window Color, and you see that we're in a CMYK document, and we have the color panel and CMYK mode, and you see still there's a hex value down here. So you can copy CMYK colors as hex, and you copy it by clicking on this hash sign. So then it's copied and you can use it in other documents. Be careful with this because, of course, it depends on your color profile. So we can just keep this in mind. And then when I go to edit and assign a different profile to this, so let's go to Japan newspaper, for instance, like so. And when I now click here, then this color value will change, of course, because the color now looks different. So when you handle documents in different color modes and then use this to copy the colors from one document to the other, that might not work out as you wanted. The next improvement we have is in the image trace. And image trace currently experiences a lot of changing in functionality. So there might always happen something in it with every new version you install. And let's check it out here. And I have this image placed in my document. And now what image trace does is try to analyze this artwork and find the best fitting option for it. So we've got the presets and it's already selected to auto detect. So it tries to find out on its own, but you can of course also check it out here and you see a preview of these settings, what they might be good for. But you can also just trace it, and then Illustrator does its thing and you see what it came up with. So the number of paths and the number of colors, which is 27, which is too many because this is just 6. So you can go into the advanced options and into the color settings and adjust that. So you can set this up as the number of colors you want to have. So 6. And then let's move it up. And Illustrator obviously did that. Also, you can, of course, adjust the advanced settings, the precision and the corners, and also the noise. You can also ignore colors. So it was possible to ignore white, but if you want to ignore a different color, then you can set this up, turn it on, and then click on this eyedropper and click on the color you want to ignore. This only works with the abutting option, but that was the case with ignore white as well. So we are used to it. Also, what you can do is, let's turn that off again so that the color doesn't get ignored. You can go into it and simplify and then apply the simplification to the image and then, of course, set up that as well. So those are the improvements in the image trays. Let's get to the next ones, and I'm going to switch to the other document again. And let's turn to the export, so we can go to export for screens, like so. And there we have another option. We can export this as WebP. And we've also got an improvement in the settings for the JPEG. There we can set up the color model, like so. We've got another thing for exporting. Let's assume you want to have a hyperlink in a PDF. Then you can select an object and go to Window Attributes and Show All. And then you can enter a hyperlink in here. So let's set this to rectangle and input my website in here and set this up. And when you now save this as a PDF. Let's do this, save it to the desktop, and yeah, there it is. I don't preserve the Illustrator options and view the PDF after saving, like so. So let's save the PDF, and there it is. And you see, there is my link. I can click on it, and there I am on my website. These are the new functions of Illustrator 27.6.1, and I hope you find them useful.